Trying to get into frame here. Hello and welcome to Is this okay? I feel like the top of my head is slightly chopped off. Hi, I'm Mallory. If you're new here, I'd love to welcome you to my world. So don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell. If I look a little rank and out of breath, well, let me tell ya. I've been contemplating making this video because it's not like a happy go lucky where I'm gonna be like, yeehaw, and extra perky, but I've had a lot on my mind and I thought, why not share it with you all, and hopefully by the time you're seeing this, I'm in a much better place. But I started 3 weeks ago. I started slowly going downhill and spiraling into what I now, I think, can 95% plus confidently say is depression. The reason I'm not saying it's 100% is because I feel like it's not a typical depression and there might be other factors. Basically, I think, you know, for me, like, depression and anxiety go hand in hand, and while I started not feeling the greatest, I thought it was something else. I thought it was, like, some wacky hormones, and me being a lady, I just thought things needed to play out, give myself, like, a week and a half, whatever, I should be fine. And nothing, you know, came to sorts that would indicate why I thought I was feeling the way that I was feeling. And my anxiety was getting bad to the point where, okay, this, like, as I like to call it, functional dizziness, meaning the room is slightly spinning and I am dizzy, but I can, for the most part, steadily walk around the house and, like, not, like, hold on to furniture or walls or need to be escorted, like, from my bed to the bathroom, like, holding on to my mom, things like that. Like, I'm able to do stuff. I do have my moments where I'm like, whoa. And it's like, okay, take a deep breath, girl. Like, take it easy. Because I know it's all stress-induced. As I've talked about prior, at some point in the future, which is most likely going to happen sooner than later, I will be moving, and I don't want to move. There's a lot of things going on. I've talked about my grandma, you know, is her house, it's weird, like, there's a for sale sign in the lawn. My brother, who knows, there's, you know, what him and his family end up doing. There's just a lot of talk, and, you know, my mom wants to downsize, so there's, like, a lot going on, and that alone has been very stressful on me, so it's caused my anxiety to kind of skyrocket, which has caused me to be really tense, and I started you know, shaking again, and, like, all up my upper body, like, my back and shoulder blade area is, like, very tight, and it's, like, a massage would probably be nice. And at times it gets bad where, like I said, like, I'll shake, or it gets, like, very painful because it's, like, stuff's now pinching on a nerve. That's very unpleasant. My heating pad's always been my best friend, but more so these days. Sometimes at night, I try to, like, wrap it around my shoulders as best as I can, because it's just a flat, big old, like, rectangle. It's not molded to fit your shoulders. So I do the best that I can to, like, lay it on my upper back and try to be in a comfortable position in bed. I'm currently been binge-watching Army Wives on Netflix, and I'm on the last season right now. I just took a break from watching it because I don't want to, like, I'll, like, go through it real fast. I swear I'm going to finish the season tonight or sometime tomorrow, and I don't know what I'm going to watch next. I haven't figured that out yet. But, so anxiety, like, and then just, like, obviously I have two sleep disorders, and they're beyond, like, out of whack. It's to the point now where I am going to bed that the earliest is like 4 a.m. and the latest is like 6 in the morning. Like, I am up all night, all day long. I feel like my legs are made out of lead. My eyelids are also made out. Like, everything is just exhausting to me. And it's morphed now to where I just randomly cry for no apparent reason, or I'm crying about sad things. And I'm using quotes because, like, in the show Army Wives, sad stuff does happen. I'm not gonna spoil it in case y'all never seen it and you want to, but it's fictional, you know? None of it's real, it's just actors acting. And I know that, like, the logic part of me is like, this is all fake, but yet I'm blubbering like an idiot. And then it makes me think of real life things that have happened in my life where now I'm crying because of that, or it's just out of the blue, I just cry. I can't tell you, like, what caused the trigger. Nothing, like, there wasn't a specific, like, trigger per se. I think just everything's going on, like, you're just, and then I just, and I have, like, I don't really leave the house. I only, like, go out on Wednesdays, and, this past Wednesday, I slept through my alarm. Like, I was in a coma. Like, you couldn't wake me if you wanted to. And I haven't done that in a really long time, so that was concerning for my mom. Of course, how I have been lately is very concerning and upsetting to my mom. There goes Squeaky. And it's just, things just, right? So all day long, I'm just like, I don't know how I'm going to do it. And some days, I'm like, I need a nap. I'm like beyond exhausted. I'll take like a 15 minute nap. You know, I don't sleep for hours in the daytime. Just like a little something, you know, like a cat nap, thinking it'll be like if I had taken a cup of coffee or something. And so I'll take a nap and then I wake up still just as tired as ever. So it's like all it does is I get to escape reality for a little bit. And then, like, almost every morning when I wake up, I feel like I'm short of breath and my heart's beating a little bit. And it's, like, it's weird because I didn't wake up from, like, an anxiety dream or, like, a nightmare or something, like, scary. And I don't know, just your average mundane things seem, like, impossible to do. And I don't have any motivation, passion, drive, desire for much other than just to, like, be in bed and do nothing, because I don't have the energy for much. And then occasionally, like, I'll get bored, but yet I'm so tired, and then I get frustrated, and then I'll just end up crying. The other day I got angry, and then I went from, like, angry to then I was crying. And I was just like, what the heck? So now I'm starting to question if, because I do have a mood disorder, if that's, like, you know, acting up and I need to go back on mood stabilizers or, you know, take a higher dosage of an antidepressant, or try a different antidepressant. I feel like I need this specific medication that has a stimulant in it, because it would be like, maybe if I take it in the morning, it'll, like, wake me up, I don't know, and help me focus and get through the day. I just feel discombobulated and not happy. Just, and my back recently is now out, and that's been stressing me out. And I know my back's out from stress, maybe depression. Because you have, like, anxiety and depression of the mind, but you also have anxiety and depression in the body. Sometimes it doesn't, like, affect you mentally, but physically it can. And so just, like, everything just, like, ugh. And, like, last night I was miserable. Like, I was in bed at, like, almost 5 o'clock in the morning, just sitting up crying because I'm like, I can't take it anymore. I've been laying on my stomach, so my back's in, like, a natural, like, C curve. I'm trying to get that disc back in place. I'm trying to remember my physical therapy exercises. And so because my back is the way that it is, my left leg is, like, not right. And it's stressing me out. And I keep telling myself, like, yes, it's uncomfortable. No, you're not enjoying this. But how many times have you gone through this before? Like, you know what it is. There's no need to stress out and think, like, the worst. because it's not. You just gotta, you know, and I'm gonna be spending the weekend with my dad because I haven't had like a lot of one-on-one time with him lately. He's been really busy. And then I was supposed to go out to dinner with him, like I think it was last week or the week before. I can't remember anymore. Things just all blur together, and I couldn't. But what's funny is the littlest things can make you feel somewhat better. So if you ever find yourself having the blues, or you're just really melancholy or down and out, it's just brushing your teeth and your hair and washing your face, like, because you go days on end and, you know, you're just so, like, beat down. You don't have the energy to, like, take care of yourself. And so just doing something as simple as, like, brushing your hair or changing your shirt. Like, I live in, like, loungewear, comfy, like, pajama clothes. Like, I've been in this Scotty shirt for a few days, not gonna lie. I'm like, I should change it. I've been wearing... They're pants. They're like sweatpants, but they're really lightweight, which I love. And I wear them as like pajama bottoms. So just even if you all you want to be in is like pajamas or comfortable like loungewear, even like exercise clothes, putting something new on every day or at least like more frequently than you have been. Just those littlest things kind of make you feel human again. And more normal, like I'm trying to take care of the household stuff, like, you know, making sure I'm still feeding my cat and all that, because I don't really eat. That's the thing, all day long, like, I'm not really drinking, so I'm getting dehydrated, I get headaches, it's just not fun. I just don't want to eat, like, I either am not hungry, I don't have an appetite, that's probably the same thing, or I don't have, like, a hankering for anything, like, nothing's like, oh yeah, that sounds really good and appealing to me, because nothing does. It's a struggle to eat. I've been living off of, like, all last week was, like, PB&Js, like, around, like, 3 or 4 o'clock, you know, all day long. It just, I don't eat, but being hypoglycemic, someone asked me about this, and I wrote back to them, because they wanted to know if it was, like, a diabetic or non-diabetic hypoglycemia, and I don't have diabetes. I just suffer with low blood sugar. So what happens is when you don't eat, then your body, and then you start to feel like, hello, a little like, you feel worse than before. And then when you wait too long, you get a little fuzzy in your head, a little dizzy. Like today, I didn't start making lunch till like 4 o'clock maybe. I ended up having, because this past week I've been living off of grilled cheese sandwiches now. I made 2 grilled cheese sandwiches, but I waited too long and I started to feel like, woozy, and that always freaks me out. And I'm like holding onto the counters. I'm like, I've poured myself a glass of lemonade to try to like spike up my blood sugar. And I was just in such a panic mode that then I ate a protein bar, hoping that wasn't gonna fill me up. And then I wouldn't be able to eat my sandwiches that I had made. Cause if I don't eat anything, I mean, I'll try to eat a protein bar. I mean, there was one day where all day long, all I ate was, like, potato chips. Like, that's not good. And then the only time I kind of get hungry is at night. Start around, like, 8 o'clock. I'm like, okay, I can have dinner now. I might eat, like, a half of a sandwich or, like, a protein bar or around, like, you know, between 5 and 6 normal dinner time for me. But then I don't really have, like, a bigger meal or an actual, like, dinner till, like, 8. And then, of course, it's followed by, like, all this ice cream and cookies. Like, I'm eating way more sweets than I should. The other night, I almost devoured a whole bag of peanut butter M&Ms, and they're, like, the Easter egg ones. So they're, like, extra big. I don't know. Like, my sweet tooth is, like, active. And also, I think because there's dopamine in ice cream, and it makes you feel good. Like, the other night, I ate an ice cream bar, but then I had another one. And I could have kept on going, but I was like, girl, you need to, like, control yourself. Like, before I started going, I was able to look at something and say, okay, the serving size is, like, 3 cookies, 2 cookies, 4 pieces of chocolate, and be able to, like, work it out with myself and only eat that in a day. But now I just, like... I was like, where did all the cookies go? And then afterwards, mentally and physically, I don't feel good. Because physically, I now I have all this extra like sugar and stuff that's not really that great for you in my body. So my body feels a little like, ugh, why'd you do that? And then mentally, I'm like, you've been working hard to try to lose weight, not gain weight. Like, you just ate all those cookies. Like, what's wrong with you? So then I'm like being hard on myself and putting myself down. But it's like in the moment, I'm not thinking. I'm just, and so just like today, I was laying on the floor with an ice pack on my back, hoping that that would help with any like inflammation that's going on. Cause I'm like dying. I'm struggling with my back, and now I'm just like, great. I'll probably end up back in physical therapy, and I'll need PT, and you need a doctor to write you a script. I'm like, what am I gonna do? Like, all my doctors are leaving me. It sucks. And like, I just have all this medical stuff I need to take care of, but I haven't gotten to it yet. There's dental stuff I gotta do, but I haven't, cause like, I don't leave the house. I haven't been driving. Just because there's times I'm supposed to go places, but I'm just like, I'm slightly dizzy, and I've been up like all night long. The other day I got like 5 hours and 30 minutes of sleep, and one of my friends was like, kind of like, oh, that's good. I'm like, for me, I'm like, 5 hours and 30 minutes of sleep? That was maybe from like 5 something in the morning, getting up at like 12:45. I don't know. It was like not, you know, a regular timeline for one's sleep. And then like my friend got engaged, and I was like, oh my gosh, like I was just like so happy for her. And I immediately, like, because the minute I knew that her boyfriend at some point, I didn't know when, but I knew soon, like sometime between a few weeks prior into her birthday, which is in May, he was gonna propose. I like got a present for her, and then I wrapped it all up, and I wanted to go over and congratulate them in person, but they weren't home, and immediately like that just like was a buzzkill. And I know it's not their fault, it's just me and how I am right now. I went from like, oh, this is like being in like a happy mood, to then all of a sudden being like, okay, I was very bothered by it, and I was trying to not let it like eat me up. But so I got, you know, some information, and she will be available on sometime on Sunday, so I might try to go over on Sunday to see her. And in the meantime, I was able to get her something else that I wanted, which was a bridal magazine. It was like the best of everything for 2017 for New Jersey. And yeah, but like my big outing was going to Lily Singh, her book signing, which was not what I had expected, but she's really sweet, and I was like happy to like have a hug from her and like have a photo with her, because she's on my vision board, and she's kind of near Ellen and like Hannah Hart, Mamrie Hart, and Grace Helbig. I'm like, maybe I'll meet them next. Someone messaged me and was like, I didn't know you know Lily. I'm like, I just met her. Like, we're not BFFs or anything, but that would be awesome. And I'm starting, started her book, and which you may have all seen. I have 2 copies now. This is not the autographed one. This one's the one that came in the mail. And I'm in like the, how many, there's like sections in here, right? Well, part 1 to 4, and I'm in part 1, and I'm about to start chapter 4 of part 1. And then I learned that if you buy this book, if you're wondering, in Target, you get an extra bonus chapter. I hate when things, stores do that. Like Walmart with their CDs, it's like, oh, you get extra bonus songs and stuff. I'm like, I already just bought the deluxe album on iTunes, and now you're saying I can get even more if I bought a CD in Walmart, and now like Target with Lily's book. But I'm not like, as long as her book's still being sold at Target, I can just read the chapter, the missing chapter on Target, right? There's your silver lining. So yeah, it's just, I haven't been great. And it's like the second time I cried in therapy when talking about the prospects of moving and trying to like, oh, where would we move to and what type of living arrangements and like all this stuff. And then people are asking me questions, and by people I mean my mom and like my therapist. And then I'm just like, you know, and then I just start crying my eyes out. My brain is very scattered, and this video is kind of long, but like, I just came up to my room a few minutes ago because I was like, oh, I should like do some laundry. Like, all my bedding, my bed sheets and everything really should be washed. One of my blankets is like covered, part of it is covered in cat hair. Because my comforter, I still haven't put that back on my bed yet because I thought I was going to get to my bed sheets first because Squeaky coughed up some hairballs. And I keep having to wash blankets and things, but I just came upstairs, I looked at my bed, and I looked at her, and I was like, this task that I normally do by myself, no matter what time of the day it is, I get it done, just for the first time, seems like a daunting project, and it seems just like a lot of work. And I just took one look at it and I was like, nope, not gonna happen today. So I figured maybe my dad helped me if I can't muster up and do it. Part of me is like, you'll feel so much better if you do it yourself. And you just like, start with one pillowcase at a time, baby steps. But all that ended up happening was I felt like crying and I felt very defeated. And I just wanted to go back downstairs on the couch. Part of me is like, it's 5:07, you should start thinking about dinner, but I'm also like, I'm not that hungry, and I probably will end up just taking like a hot, relaxing bath tonight, and just soaking my body, and put in some pink Himalayan bath salts, and maybe some Epsom salts, and just, it's really disgusting outside today. That's the thing, whenever I have to go somewhere, it's like nasty out, and I don't want to drive in that weather, especially how I'm feeling, so it's kind of like a regression, I don't know. But, I keep thinking in my head, like, well, what can I do to feel better? Like, what steps do I need to take? Like, do I need to, like, reevaluate my medications? Do I need to just, like, push through stuff? With, again, like, getting new ideas and reading Lily's book, will, like, that just inspire me and spark something that, like, relight my fire? I honestly don't know, and I'm confused by so many things right now that I don't really know, and all I can do is gather information, write down all my thoughts and feelings, and try to work something out and assemble a team to help me get through these next couple of months. Because it's a given that I'm moving, clearly. And that just does not sit well with me at all. And I try to act like it doesn't bother me, but it really does. And, I'm trying to work those feelings and emotions out now, but I have a feeling when the time comes, it's going to be not fun at all. It's going to, I don't even know. And that's why I'm just like, I need a team of people or medications or something to help me get through this rough patch, because it's not going to get any easier. And not knowing things. Sometimes I think I see snowflakes, but that can't be. I think it's just rain. Although up in Vermont today, they're getting snow. Weird, some places are getting snow. The rest of the world is rain. It's raining in Florida. Like, it's raining here too. So, you know, I have friends in Florida, so I don't know. I mean, there's just a lot going on, and I just wanted to make this video to be like, the littlest things can make you feel great, but depending on where you are after you've done them, you can also feel very exhausted. Like, I thought we were gonna go over to my neighbor's last night because I really wanted to see my friend. And like, I came upstairs, like, I kind of washed my face a little bit because I had been crying a lot, and I had like mascara, like, and And I brushed my hair because it was a mess. I brushed my teeth so my breath was real stinky. I put a hat on. I put deodorant on. I was about to put on pants, but I was like, I had to take a break. And I'm sitting on the toilet, like with the lid, obviously the lid's down, just sitting on top of it. And I'm trying to figure out, can I do this or not? To then learn that, again, like I mentioned earlier, Ashley won't be home till Sunday. So I was like, okay, off went the hat. And I went back downstairs on the couch. And I don't know, it's like, talking to you all on camera, like, I can laugh a little, like, about it, but it really isn't all that fun or funny. And I know most people prefer and enjoy watching more perky videos or when they don't really, I don't know, but if I'm gonna be honest and share my life with you, this is me and this is part of my life. Stuff happens and I get depressed and I don't talk about depression a lot. I talk more about Asperger's and anxiety because my depression's kind of been dormant. And now it's like, finally, you know, I don't know. There's things that remind me back when 2006 when I had a nervous breakdown. But I wasn't dizzy then, but now I have the dizzy component. And that is something that I'm worried about. I'm worried about it, like, taking a whole other level, and then that dysfunctional dizzy will no longer be dysfunctional. Functional, like being able to function while being dizzy. Like, I'm afraid that that's gonna not be the case, and I'm just gonna be bed bound or couch bound or whatever, and I'm gonna be a hot, hot, hot mess, more so than I am now. So that's why, like, while I'm quasi okay, I wanna get things all my ducks in a row before anything gets worse, because there's a good chance. And now I'm just like, great, like, the last thing I need is to not be able to drive and have to, like, go to physical therapy and need a ride when I could normally, under different circumstances, take myself. So, like, I'm just stressing about a lot of things, and a lot of things I don't even know they're gonna happen or not, or a lot of stuff's out of my control, and that's not good. And then, like, earlier today, there was some drama online, and I was just like, are you effing kidding me with this? Like, for the love of God, like, please, just people, y'all, like, it was my friends, and not friends, just, like, Facebook acquaintances. Like, why can't we all just get along and, like, people just behave themselves? I don't know, but that's my story. Whew. I'm gonna go now. I don't know what I'm gonna do exactly, but I definitely am very uncomfortable with my whole back situation. I was like, oh, you should do some yoga for lower back pain. Try to, like, stretch it out or do what you gotta do, but I don't even have the energy for that. I'm, like, putting heat on it and ice on it. I put a patch on last night to kind of numb the pain. Something I got at, like, Rite Aid. It's, like, has lidocaine and menthol or something. I don't know what the heck it is. You know, it's like a salon pass patch. I don't know. Anyways, that's my story. I'm gonna head on downstairs, figure things out, straighten up some messes, try to anyway, and then I might just come back upstairs and plop myself in the bathtub, or just take a hot, relaxing shower, because sometimes that can make you feel like a human being again, too. You know, it's getting all cleaned up, even though you're not going anywhere. So if you have any comments, questions, suggestions, feel free to leave those down below. And while you're down there, don't forget to check the description box. You can find me on social media. I'm pretty much everywhere. Come say hey. Please, if you haven't subscribed and you'd like to, click on my face. And if you want to watch something else, most likely where I'm in a better state of mind, feel free to do so. And thank you guys so much for being here and for watching and all your love and support. And as always, till next time, keep it quirky.